Let's talk about Hillary Clinton. So from the Christian Post, and I'm just wondering if she'd be an acceptable Christian to you because she claims to be a Christian. So here's a story from the Christian Post. It says, Clinton once attended prayer meetings with Republican senators Sam Brownback and Rick Santorum. While a U.S. senator, Clinton attended a bipartisan prayer meeting, which included some of the Senate's most conservative Republicans like Sam Brownback and Rick Santorum. At one of those meetings, Brownback stopped short of telling his testimony to ask Clinton's forgiveness for the sins of feeling hatred toward her and saying derogatory things about her, according to The Atlantic. Quote, I came here today prepared to share about this experience in my life that has caused great suffering, the result of which has deepened my faith, but I'm overcome now with only one thought, Brownback said during seeing Clinton in the meeting. After asking for her forgiveness, Clinton said she appreciated the apology and forgave him. Ever since then, Clinton found it easier to work with both sides of the political divide and even co-sponsored a bill with Brownback. She has worked with conservatives and liberals alike, showing that she is able to use her faith in the political realm to foster good for her causes and agenda. So what do you think about that?
Well, Sam Brownback is a great guy. I spent parts of 2014 traveling the state of Kansas speaking on my book with him. So I've met him. We've spent time together. I really enjoy him, and I appreciate what he did for Hillary Clinton because we're not supposed to hate people. We're supposed to work with them and try to lead them in the right way. Having said that, anybody can say they're a Christian. Anybody, you know, same thing as Donald Trump. You can always say you're a Christian. The question is not whether you're a Christian. The question is, are you living the life that, in the sense of for a president, are you? Do you believe in the principles of Christianity and the principles that we hold dear? And that's what I would judge them. So I'm not going to judge Hillary Clinton on her Christianity. I'm going to judge her on her principles and what the law, kind of law she'll do. And I think she's a socialist. I think she's an elitist. I think she believes that the rules don't apply to her, applies to everybody else. I think that she's she has lied to us about the Benghazi. She's, you know, you can go down the whole thing, lied to us about the emails. I think she keeps bad company. You know, I think she's in the pocket of the Saudi Arabians who donated to her. So I think there are a lot of reasons why we shouldn't have Hillary Clinton. It's got nothing to do with her religion. I think if she may be a Christian, I pray that she is. I don't get the impression she is, but that's between her and God.
Well,
and
you don't want to judge. Well, sometimes when you speak about Christian principles or whatever, I'm kind of thinking, what do you think are Christian principles? I mean, for example, the Catholics have like quite a bit of a different way of life than, for example, Baptists and Mormons. And if you support Romney, that'd be kind of weird because who's more of a Christian, Romney or Hillary?
Again, you can be a non-Christian and still adhere to Christian principles, right? I think we've seen that over and over again.
So you think that'd be the case with Romney, being a non-Christian with Christian principles?
See, what's interesting about Mormons is though that Mormons and Christians share a lot of the same basic principles, right?
But they have radical different beliefs, and Mormons claim to be Christians, but most Christians would say no, they're not Christians.
Yeah, we see a difference in what they believe. We don't believe their God is limited in time and space. He was born on the planet Kolob. Our God is the one that created the whole universe. So it's a different God altogether. But that doesn't mean that his basic family values are different from mine. I mean, I agree with Romney on a lot of things. Now, I personally don't think Romney was much of a conservative. I think he became pro-life because it was convenient for him. You know, he was the one who created Romney Care. So there were a lot of reasons why I didn't like Romney. Having said that, there are good reasons. I think there are more principles that I share with him than I share with Hillary Clinton. I think Hillary Clinton is just pretending to be whatever people want her to be so that she can get elected. And she's not doing a very good job of it.
Okay, well, I guess we're out of time. And again, I enjoyed our conversation. And so thanks for joining me.
Thank you, Bernie. I hope we can do it again sometime.
Okay. We'll talk to you later. Bye.
Bye.